hepatitis is a condition where you have inflammation of the liver. Inflammation of the liver means that there is swelling of the liver, and therefore the liver is not able to function well. There are various causes for this, where you can get certain conditions that may cause this swelling of the liver. Among them is you can get the series of viral hepatitis, and the most common ones we can get is depending on the age, but we have hepatitis A, we have hepatitis B, we have hepatitis C. There's also hepatitis D and E, but D and E are not very common. You can also get hepatitis from certain drugs or certain medications that you can use. Even the simple Panadol or paracetamol that you use, if you take in excess, you can also get hepatitis. That is related to drugs. You can also get hepatitis from use of excessive alcohol, and that can also give you a form of hepatitis. There's also hepatitis that is related to certain conditions that are called autoimmune, where the body basically attacks its organs. You can also get that type of hepatitis. So to diagnose hepatitis, what we tend to do is, number one, there are certain clinical signs that we look for in the patients. Sometimes when you develop hepatitis, you may notice there's a change in the color of your eyes. You get this yellowish tinge that may occur. You also notice it in the body. Sometimes you may get itchiness all over the body. And then also to diagnose it actually requires more of a laboratory investigation. And what we do is we do a test called a liver function test. And in this test, there are certain markers that we look for that tell us that there is inflammation within the liver. So it depends on the type of hepatitis that you have. And for example, if you're talking of the viral hepatitis, if you have hepatitis A or hepatitis B, there are actually vaccines that you can get. And this would prevent you from, if you're exposed to the virus, from getting this form of hepatitis. Of course, the other ones related to drugs or alcohol, the best thing is to do is to, if you can, is to avoid certain medications or taking the appropriate doses of the medications. And of course, avoiding using excessive alcohol. Some of the symptoms that you might have when you're having hepatitis. This is what you call acute hepatitis, a hepatitis that has occurred over a short period of time. Because of some of the changes that may occur, you may get a bit, you may get nausea, you may get vomiting, you may get diarrhea in some of the causes, you may get generalized weakness. So definitely when it is acute hepatitis, it may to affect your normal activities. There's another type of hepatitis, some types especially associated with hepatitis B or C, you may get what is known as a chronic hepatitis. And sometimes some of the patients are just carriers, so you may not have any obvious symptoms, but the virus is there, and this one requires some blood investigations to actually pick them up, screening for the hepatitis viruses, the B and C especially. Hepatitis can be transmitted, usually the viral hepatitis can be transmitted through, for example, B and C through exposure of bodily fluids, and this is possible that you can get hepatitis from one person to another by exposure to this. Because the issue we have with hepatitis, especially now we're talking about the viral hepatitis, is that some of them, for example, hepatitis B or C might be silent. You may not notice any symptoms that you have. This is what we're talking about. Chronic forms, or if you're a carrier, you may not notice any symptoms. And the thing with this is that it causes some ongoing liver damage, where you may get a condition known as liver cirrhosis in future. With liver cirrhosis is usually where there is significant scarring of the liver. And this liver cirrhosis sometimes can also progress to developing cancer of the liver. So it's important to check, know your status, and also do your liver function test and see. I think it's important to go to hospital, have yourself screened, do your liver function test, and also do the screening for hepatitis, especially B and C, especially if they are, especially if, for example, if you know if your family members may have been exposed to the virus.